to do today is we're going to do a HIIT-based workout. So I'll do a quick run through of the four exercises we're going to use. We'll do a very short warm-up, the 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off, three times through your HIIT workout, and then we'll do some stretching at the end. So the four exercises we're going to do, first one is we're going to do a squat tap. So you take a nice wide stance for your squat. You're going to drop it down, and as you come up, you're going to push through one leg, do a toe tap. Down, toe tap, down, toe tap. Again, we'll do that for 30 seconds, and then we'll rest for 30 seconds. Our second exercise is going to be a plank up and down. So you're going to start in your full plank and come down onto the elbows, and then back up. Remembering to swap arms, so you're not going up and down on the same arms. If it's easier, please feel free to do it on the knees. Still coming down and up. It just takes some of the strain out of the arms and shoulders. The third exercise we're going to do today is going to be a stepping lunge. So you're going to take a nice long step and drop down and up, making sure that you're not going too far forward. Stepping and then down, up, stepping back, step, down, up, stepping back, and keep going for the 30 seconds. Fourth exercise we're going to do today is a V-set. You can either do it as a hold or as a movement. So you can either lift up, down, up, down, or hold. Or if you're feeling super strong, you can hold it, take it to a full V. Alright. So as I said, we'll start with our mini warm up. Really move the arms now. And come to standing. We're going to rotate the arms. Right arm back. And then forwards. Okay, so we do the other one. Take it back. And forwards. Good. So we're going to go into our first exercise now, so that will be our squat taps. So I'm going to start my fancy little beeper. Get yourself into position and go. Squat, tap, squat, tap. Remembering to alternate your legs, sitting it back, pulling in that belly button, tucking in that tail. You're halfway now. Keep it going. Five, four, three, two, and one. So we're going to have our 30 seconds rest, and then we're going to go into our planks. So feel free to come down into position. So either on the knees or on the hands and feet. As I said before, making sure that you alternate. So you go down on one, back up on that one, and then down on the other side, and back up on that side. Get yourself into position, and go. Down, up, down, and up. Again, keeping that core tight. 10 seconds left. Five, four, three, two, one, and rest. So we're going to come back up onto our feet now, and we're going to do our stepping lunges. So again, remembering, core tight, tuck the tail under, step on the left. Drop down, come up, step back, step out on the right. Okay, get yourself into position and ready. Step forwards, down, up, back. Forwards, down, going. You can use your hands and arms for balance if need be. You can use them on the leg. 10 seconds left. Three, two, one, and rest. So we're going to go into our final exercise, which is the V-sit. So get yourself nice and comfy. And again, either get yourself into position, lift and down, lift, down. Have it as a 30 second hold, or you can take it from here and extend. We are going to do it three times through. So you can always do the easier version now, or the harder version now, and go down from there. So, we're going. I can't really talk and do the extended, so I'm just gonna hold. Again, thinking about keeping that core tight. Really think about pushing the chest up to keep that back nice and straight. Five, four, three, two, one, and rest. So we'll have about a minute's rest now, and then we'll do a second set. Just waiting for this to count down. Okay, so we've got another 20 seconds and then we'll do it all again. So remember, it's our squat and tap, squat, tap, beating it. We're then doing the plank down and up, either on feet or knees. We're then doing our stepping lunge, alternating legs, and then our V-sit. Okay, so get yourself in position for your squat taps. And go. Tap, down, tap. Good. Remembering to sit it nice and low, holding that core nice and tight, tucking that tail under, keeping the chest up. If you need to do it slower, please do. You're almost there already. Five, four, three, two, one, and stop. 30 seconds rest, and we'll go into our next one. It's a bit hot in this gazebo. So again, as I said, we're either gonna do it on feet and hands, hands and knees, whatever is more comfortable for you. Get yourself into position. And go. Down and up. Swap arms. Down and up. Remembering, keep that core tight. And swapping the arms. Ten seconds left. Five, four, three, two, and one. Rest there. Do 30 seconds and we'll go into our third exercise, which is the lunge. So again, remembering, keep that core tight, tail under. We're going to alternate legs. So get yourself into position and go when you're ready. Stepping forwards, down, up, back. Again, using whatever you need to keep the balance. You can take the arms out wide. You can have them in front. You can even use them to lean on the leg. Remembering to step back. Swap legs. stop there. And we'll have our 30 seconds rest before we go into our final V-sits. Then again, we'll take another minute's rest before we do it a third time. So if you did the harder one last time but you're feeling a bit more tired now, you can always do the medium and just do a hold. Or you can continue with the harder, or you can do the easy. Get yourself into position. I'm going to do the hold. As I said, you could do up and down, or that way, whatever is easiest for you. Wherever you are, pull in that belly button nice and tight. Push the chest up to keep the back nice and flat. Keep the arms by the side of the legs. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. So we're gonna have a minute's rest again, then we'll do our final set, and then we'll do a bit of stretching. I'm gonna go grab a drink. Keep resting. Ignore the beeping. So we've got another 20 seconds, and then we'll start for our final run through. My dog doesn't know what to do with herself. She just keeps wandering around. Too hot for it today, bless her. Okay, so we're gonna start with those squat taps. So get yourself into position. And we're gonna go when you're ready. Down. Remember alternating in the leg that you're pushing on, holding in that belly, tucking the tail under, keeping that chest nice and high. 10 seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're going to come down onto the floor. Then we'll do the plank ups and downs. Again, either on hands and feet or hands and knees. We're going to get into position. And go when you're ready. Remembering, alternating your hands and arms. That's it, keep it going. Keep that core tight. 10 seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. 30 seconds and we'll go into our lunges. Please make sure that when you can, you're drinking in between. Especially on these lovely hot days. Typical we have hot weather when we can't enjoy it. So get yourself into position. And we're going to step forwards and down. Other leg. Keep it going. Again, keeping that core tight, tail tucked under, and stepping forwards, dropping down. Ten seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're going into our last one now, our V-sit. This time, see if you can do a full 30 second hold on your V-sit. So we're not worrying about any movement on this one. We're just gonna keep it a static hold. We're gonna really try and work that core hard. So get yourself into position. Arms by the sides. Finding your balance, lifting your legs. I'm gonna hold, keeping the chest high, feet high. you start to drop down, just tighten everything back up. We're halfway now. Keep that shoulder, chest nice and open, shoulders back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. So we'll take 30 seconds rest, and then we'll do our stretching, and we're done for today. So as we're on the floor, we're starting off on the floor with our stretches. So the first stretch that we're going to do, if I face you, is we're going to do feet together, knees wide, and stretch the inside of the hips. Holding on to the feet, just pulling yourself gently, trying to keep the back nice and straight, because we want to stretch in the hips, not the lower back. Release the stretch, we're going to take right leg out in front, bring the left leg a bit closer, and we're just going to get hold of whatever we can, leg, ankle, foot. But we're trying to get a stretch in that hamstring. So don't worry about trying to feel it in the lower back or anything like that. And if you're feeling it in the back of the knee, just bend the knee slightly until you're just feeling it in that hamstring. Stay here for a little bit longer. Release and swap legs. So we're pulling right leg in, left leg out. Again, just getting hold of that foot. And you're just gonna do the stretch how it feels good for you. If you need to bend that knee, holding on to whatever you can, leg, ankle, foot, toes. You're just gonna hold it there. Just let that stretch go off a bit. Release. Good. We're going to come up to standing and we're going to stretch the quads. So if you need something to hold on to, please do. If not, we're just going to stand on the left leg first, get hold of the right foot, bring the knees together, pull the foot towards the bottom, push the hips slightly forwards, and really get a good stretch on that quad. And we're just going to hold that till that stretch goes off a little. Release, and we'll swap sides. So again, pulling the knees together, pulling the foot towards the bottom, pushing the hips slightly forwards, and really feeling that stretch on that quad. Release. Final couple of stretches. We're just going to take the hands together. We're going to push the hands away, dropping the head into the shoulders slightly. Get a stretch across the upper back. Release the hands, take them behind the back. And we're just going to push them away to stretch the chest. Might even feel that a little bit in the shoulders. And done.